Hi, my name is Eiko Pras. I work at the University of Twente in the Netherlands, and in this video I will provide a short overview of Internet Management Standards. I'll explain that there are three main types of standards: Management Information Bases, the Structure of Management Information, and the SNMP Protocols. The first category of standards are the MIP standards, and MIP stands for Management Information Base. Although there's conceptually a single management information base, the information contained in these MIPs is divided over hundreds of MIP modules. So we have standardized within the IETF hundreds of MIP module definitions. Of these definitions, most are still at the proposed standard level. Some, however, have already moved to the draft standard level, and there are even a few that are at standard level. The goal of a MIP module definition is to define what management information exists within a certain system. The second category of Internet Management Standards are the SMI standards. SMI stands for Structure of Management Information. In fact, there are two versions of the SMI defined. First, SMI version 1 is defined in RFC 1155. The original MIP modules were defined according to SMI version 1. The second version of SMI, which is an improvement over the version 1, is defined in RFC 2578. This version, of course, is also at standard level, and new MIP module definitions are supposed to be defined according to the SMI version 2. The goal of the SMI is to define the syntax of management information. The third category of Internet Management Standards define the SNMP, the Simple Network Management Protocol. Like the SMI, there are multiple versions of SNMP defined. The original version was SNMP version 1 and defined in RFC 1157. Despite the fact that this version is still widely used in practice, the IETF has declared this version to be historic. The problems with SNMP version 1 are that at one side its performance is relatively poor, and at the other side its security mechanism, which relies on community strings, so say passwords, is relatively weak. These community strings are transported over the network in an unencrypted way. For that reason, the IETF started in the early 90s to work on a second version of SNMP, SNMP version 2. Unfortunately, the IETF could not agree on an improved security mechanism. Therefore, SNMP version 2 has still the same community-based security mechanism as SNMP version 1. That is the reason why SNMP version 2 is called SNMP version 2C. The C stands for community. Note that during standardization, many other variants were also under discussion. SNMP version 2C is defined in three standards, three RFCs, RFC 1901, 1909, and 1910. Like SNMP version 1, however, SNMP version 2C is declared to be historic. Still, we'll see a lot of environments where SNMP version 2 is being used in practice, primarily because of the better efficiency compared to SNMP version 1. The third version of SNMP is version 3, which is defined in RFC 3411 till RFC 3416. These RFCs are all at standard level. New environments are encouraged to use SNMP version 3. The goal of the SNMP protocols is to define how management information should be exchanged over the network.